Capabilia. Hello, Capabilia.
Your first runner-up is Elizabeth Medina.
At yan nga po, nakita natin ang aking pagkapanalo. Hindi ako. Nakangarap lang po ako maging beauty queen because hindi naman tayo lahat ay destined for that dream. You know, the glitz and glamour of everything. At para nga po, iyan naman ang ating pag-usapan about we have with us partner. Alam mo, ikaw na nga mag-introduce nito. Mas bagay
sa lalaki. Ikaw mag-introduce niya dahil kala ko ikaw nga yung nanalo kanina.
Pwede na.
May pagkahawig ko eh.
Ina-gusto na yung pagkapanalo niya. Sino ba ito makakasawin partner?
Ewan ko kung nasaan siya ngayon. Pero siya ho ang first Filipina Miss New Mexico USA. Filipina to. Si Miss Suzanne Perez sa makakasama natin via Zoom. Good morning, Suzanne. Dani Atrika.
Hello, how are you guys doing?
Okay, we're very fine. Where are you right now?
I am in the United States. I'm currently in California right now for vacation.
Oh, okay. So you stay there in California?
I stay in New Mexico. I'm doing my master's program in New Mexico right now. But since it's summer for you know, the United States, I'm in California because that's where my family lives.
Okay. So congratulations. So how does it feel to be, you know, first time, I think, in 8 years that we have won that, and you're very close now to being sana Filipina Miss USA. Are you that confident, or what is your initial reaction when you won that particular? You said Miss USA, Miss Mexico USA.
Miss New Mexico USA. It was absolutely crazy. I'm 25 now, but when I was 16, 17 years old, it was my ultimate number one dream to go to Miss USA, to walk the stage as Miss USA, to be one of the only Filipinas to be on that stage. But in my head, I thought it was impossible. You look at these beauty queens, you look at, you know, Catriona Gray, Pia Wurzbach, it just seems like, you know, it's an impossible dream. But I just kept going. You know, I worked physically, mentally, spiritually. I made sure I was really prepared before I competed for the title. Uh-huh. And when I competed, I ended up winning. It's such a dream. I wake up every morning still like, this is real life. I'm, you know, representing New Mexico. I'm representing not only my state, but I'm representing the Filipino community.
Your parents are, Suzanne, both Filipinos?
Yeah, so my mom...
From where?
She's from Surigao del Sur, so Bisli.
Surigao, both of them? Surigao?
My dad is from Baguio.
Baguio, I see. So you grew up in Mexico? Where in Mexico?
New Mexico. I grew up in California.
But in California.
But I moved to New Mexico to go to school and then compete.
I see. But we're just wondering, marunong ka ba mag-Tagalog, Suzanne?
I can understand. I understand Tagalog and Bisaya, but responding back is I'm still working.
Taglish.
Yes, Taglish. Taglish is perfect.
I think we're feeling the pressure right now. We only have 20 words in English that we have on target for interviews like this, you know. But you're going to be representing New Mexico, the state of New Mexico, for the Miss USA pageant. This is for this the upcoming year for 2022 or 2023?
2022. So there's no announced date yet. We're still waiting on it to happen, but it's projected to be in October.
October. Uh-huh. Where?
25. No projection pa nga, partner. So,
wala pa kang date at saka kung saan. Wala pang venue.
Very secret.
Yeah.
For
the pageant world, I know the 25 is, that's almost reaching the end of the line, if I'm not mistaken, right? So after this, after Miss USA, what's your next plan?
Well, hopefully I win Miss USA and go to Miss Universe, which would be absolutely crazy. But aside from that, I am in school for speech language pathology. I did my bachelor's degree in communication sciences, and I'm currently in my master's for it. And my plan is to one day open my own rehabilitation clinic for speech therapy, occupational therapy, physical therapy. So aside from the pageant world, that is my number one dream that I have been working on as well.
They're always asking partner, no, for our candidates, what your advocacy is. So what is yours?
Yeah, so I really focus on disability awareness and disability rights. I have gone home to the Philippines a couple of times and volunteered my time at special needs orphanages in my community in Bisbig, actually. I provided free speech therapy over there. I visited, I met with the children. So really honing in and making sure that these children with disabilities have resources is my number one goal, especially, you know, in America and even in the Philippines. They are lacking in resources. They don't have the funds to be able to get it. And with these children, they need all the tools they need to be able to succeed. So my focus is that for pageantry.
Yeah, actually, you raised a good point. Well, in the U.S., I think it's I think you guys have a better special education system for your special needs children. But here in the Philippines, we really are lacking that. Yeah, we are lacking that, even in the metro cities, but especially in the provinces. So if ever you're going to be finishing your master's, will you be focusing on helping Filipino kids also?
Definitely, which is why I did go back to the Philippines, because I know in America, while we are still lacking, in the Philippines, it's lacking a lot more, and they definitely need a lot more time, a lot more resources, a lot more help. So being able to give back to my community, to give back to, you know, diversity, not just, you know, the Americans over here, that is my main goal as well. So definitely working with
especially the province mates of your parents sa Surigao at saka Baguio, di ba? Probably yung disability, yung programs for disabled persons, that should be, you should be helping them also there, diba?
Yes, definitely. And that is my point. Hopefully I get to go back soon eventually once, you know, the pandemic slows down a little. But I know it's getting a little bit better. But after Miss USA,
it's getting better now.
Back, and using my time to focus on my Filipino community there.
But speech pathology doesn't just focus on the needs of special children, right? Can also help out on stroke victims, stroke survivors, not victims, stroke survivors, right?
Yes, it's a very vast topic. So basically, speech pathology is any disorder, delay from the throat up. So like you said, adults who have strokes, Alzheimer's, dementia, they forget how to swallow. We really work on that. We can work on the physical aspect of helping adults learn how to eat food, how to breathe, how to talk. And then with kids as well, they don't have to have disabilities. They can just have speech delays. They can have other disorders that aren't necessarily developmental disabilities. So there's a lot of things that speech pathologists do.
So there's instances where therapies, where you can do therapies up to palliative care.
Yes. That's actually, definitely.
All right. So it's nice that you're helping kids up all the way to adults, even to the end stages of their lives. So speech pathology is actually a big thing that you can do for kids here. Do you think that you'd be able to at least have a wider reach, a wider audience when you become, cross fingers, Miss USA?
Yes, I believe that would be, you know, the biggest thing for me if I do win Miss USA. At the end of the day, we know, you know, there's stereotypes on pageantry. We look at it as just, you know, the glitz and glamour of competing, walking on stage in heels. But to me, it's way, way deeper than that, which is why I also waited until I was a little bit older to compete, because I knew if I ever had the opportunity to go to Miss USA, I wanted a deeper purpose. I wanted a deeper passion for it. Mm-hmm. So by being, you know, Miss New Mexico USA alone, or even Miss USA, hopefully I get to reach out to a way bigger audience to not just promote, you know, beauty or beauty pageants, but to promote my advocacy of helping children with disabilities.
Mm-hmm. In that competition that you won, Suzanne, no? Miss Mexico USA, how many candidates did you defeat?
In total, so there was Miss and Teen candidates together. So they had a Miss New Mexico Teen USA compete and a Miss New Mexico USA compete. In total, I believe there were about 60 contestants.
Wow, that's a lot, huh?
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, so you're the only Filipina that participated in that, you know, in that competition.
Yeah, so I was the only Filipina to compete and the only Filipina to ever win the title, and it's been going on for 70 years. 70.
Because in many beauty contests, di ba, partner, pero happy na ilang, di ba, yung nananalo, yung parents nila, either yung father is foreigner, But in your case, pareho sila eh, taga Baguio at taga Surigao. So that's very something that we should cherish, di ba, as Filipinos, na talaga both parents are Filipino. So we're very proud of you, Suzanne. So I hope between now and let's say the you know, the competition for the Miss USA, you're not allowed to leave or even visit the country, the Philippines. So.
I don't think I'm allowed to before Miss USA. I haven't, okay, you know, tried to or even got
So you'll be confined only to the US.
Yeah, for now. But if I win Miss USA, then we go to Miss Universe and that's going to be in a different country. Hopefully I'll be able to leave soon.
So may I ask, Suzanne, who was also your driving force behind this? Because, you know, in the Philippines, also like in the United States, the pageantry world is big. Even in preschool, we have like popularity contests. Who brought you into this? Your mom?
She did. So the first pageant I ever did was Miss Philippines USA when I was 16 years old, very, very young. I had no experience, nothing whatsoever, but she mentored me. She, you know, she helped me. She made me have self-confidence in myself. And with my first pageant, I was able to win second runner-up for Miss Philippines USA. And ever since then, I told her, Miss USA is my dream, Mom. I really want to go for it. And every year, you know, she's encouraged me and pushed me and kept me going.
So your mom should be very fashionable, no? Laging nakatutok sa mga fashion, you know. Siguro, because taga Surigao, eh, no? My mom is also from Surigao, so.
Oh, wow!
I can relate. Yeah, from Surigao City. You know Surigao City? Yeah.
I've heard of it, yeah. They're fashionable. My mom is always on top of her. She's better than me. Like I said, she tells me what to wear. She tells me how to act.
To walk, you know, the right, you know.
Yeah, she shows me all the sassiness of the walk.
I see. So you have also siblings there in California, or you're the only child, or what? So how old are you now, Suzanne?
It's okay. I'm 25 years old now, and I have three other siblings. I have an older brother and then two younger siblings.
And your inspiration is also your boyfriend? No boyfriend yet. Do you also like Filipino men? Or you don't care?
No.
Studies first, pageants first.
Studies.
Pageant goes first because there's a timeline in the pageant world. Mm-hmm. Up until what age are you able to compete in Miss USA?
You know, for Miss USA, it used to be 26, but they actually moved it up. So now it's 27. So if I didn't win this year, I would have had two more years to compete.
Yeah, two more years. Just move to another state and compete there so you can get another.
Suzanne, my partner wants to ask you, she texted us, how do you preserve your beautiful and sexy body? Because, you know, my partner is already sexy, but she wanted to be like you, you know, that sexy body, you know. Is there a particular diet that you follow like that?
I do follow a diet, but it's not very restrictive. I did struggle before with, you know, overeating or undereating. And I knew, you know, going into pageantry, you want to be healthy mentally. And
Yes.
So I do watch what I'm eating, but I never restrict myself from anything. So, you know, if I want to eat the dessert, I'll eat the dessert, but I'll do it in moderation.
Very cautious.
Yes. To make sure my mentality is still healthy and I'm not starving myself or, you know, being unhealthy with anything.
Mm. Oh, before we let you go, I want to know what happened during the 2 years that the pandemic struck on the pageant world. Did it differ much from before?
It did. So pageantry was actually put on hold for a little bit. I know the Miss USA, the year of the pandemic, was very different. It was televised, but the girls wore masks and they were standing really far apart from each other. So it was a whole different thing. And then this would be, you know, the second year coming back from the pandemic with pageantry, where it would be back to normal.
Mm-hmm. I think, partner, yung isa dyang asset, your asset, Suzanne, is also your long hair, no?
Yes.
When I saw the footage, you see there when you were being crowned, you have that long hair. Maganda. It's very nice. Filipina. That thing.
Yes, it's funny. I used to be blonde. I dyed my hair blonde before because you know, I was trying to fit into the American beauty standard instead of embracing, you know, my Filipina beauty, the dark hair and everything, the dark skin. But I ended up winning being natural. So that's why I'm happy about that.
Everybody's going tan, but you have it naturally. So just, accept it.
Uh-huh.
All right, Suzanne, last few words or inspirational messages for those who want to be a beauty queen like you.
Yeah, so first of all, I just want to say thank you so much for having me. It was an honor talking to you all. Going into pageantry, you want to look at it past pageantry and what you see on TV. You want to make sure you have a purpose. You want to make sure you have a passion. That's way more than just physical beauty. So if anybody is thinking about competing, I would say to just really, you know, boost your self-esteem, have that confidence in yourself to know that you're worthy of what you put yourself into and you're capable of doing it. And that's, I think, going in with that mindset this year is the reason why after 8 years, I finally won and was able to accomplish my dream of going to Miss USA.
All right. So nice to see. Wish you well.
Thank
we wish you well on the Miss USA pageant. We
Good
hope
luck.
To get it.
Thank you so much.
Good
thank
luck, Susan. We'll be praying for your success. Okay. Thank you very much, and you take care.
Thank you. You as well.
Thank you, our pure Filipina Miss New Mexico USA.
Puro-puro yan, partner. Ha?
Puro-puro
yun, ha? Hindi happy na yun, ha?
Correct. Buti nga, talagang purong Pinay nagko-compete sa ibang bansa. Dito sa atin, hap-ne-hap na lang talaga, di ba? Partner, pero doon.
Maganda, maganda yung mix nila, di ba? Ilocano, Bisaya na naman, di ba?
Yan, kaya good luck. Tingnan natin kung saan mapupunta si Suzanne. Anyway, may 2 taon pa siya para mag-grab yung crown ng Miss USA, di ba?